Hello everybody. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make static methods. Static methods are very much like mathematical functions, where you give a list of values as input and get a new value in return. There are other kinds of methods in Java. We'll get to them later. You've already made your own static methods. The main methods that contain your program so far are static methods. And now we're going to see how to make other static methods to perform other functions. Let me show you. In this segment, I'm going to show you how to create a static method that takes a number, then adds 10 to the number, and finally returns the value of that calculation. Let's start by creating a new project. I'm going to call it static methods. And inside of that, I'm going to make a new class called calculations. Open up the editor. And let's get rid of all the stuff we don't need. And put in the description. And let's create a method and call it add10. So here's what we do. Public static, that is what makes the method static. Double add10 double x. This says that this method called add10 is going to return a double, and it's going to take a double as input. Let's implement the method. We're going to return 10 plus whatever value we got passed in when we called the method up here. This is called a formal parameter, or just a parameter. Now let's compile this and run it. So right click on calculations. See the method is right here. Now in this field, I can type in a number and the method will run with that number for the value x. And there's the response. So it returned 30, which is fortunately correct. Now let me implement another method. This says it's a static method called calculate. It's going to return a double when it's done calculating, and it's going to take a double as an input when we call the method. And let's come up with an implementation. One of the reasons for using methods is that we can call other methods from within a given method. Let me show you. So here we can call add10 with the y that we were passed in. And let's see how that works. So here's the new method. I click on that. and I can put in a value here, let's say 4, and press OK, and that is the result of doing that calculation. Let me show you how this works in the debugger. Put in 4 here and run it. And so now you can see we went to this line in the program, and I'm going to say step into. You'll see that it jumps up here inside the add10 method and executes this line. If I furthermore do the step into or step, it'll come back and then return the value. There it is. While methods can only return one value, you can have as many input values as you like. Let me show you. I'm going to create a method that will greet a person given their given name and their family name. Let me show you. So public static, and this method is going to return a string. I'm going to call the method greet. It's going to take a string, that's the given name, and a string, that's the family name. And all it's going to do is return hello and then the full name. And let's see it in action. Remember, these are strings. And there you go. And that's pretty much all there is to creating simple static methods. In this segment, I'm going to show you a system for creating methods that will help you as things get more involved. I'm going to show you a series of steps that will eventually give us a correct method. This is an adaptation of a methodology called How to Design Functions from a book called How to Design Programs by Matthew Flatt et al. So let's open up the editor. And what I would like to do is to create a method that can calculate tips. So I'm going to proceed in a series of steps. The first one is to note what I'm trying to do. We call this the purpose. And in this case, it's to calculate a tip. Next, I'm going to write down what kinds of data the method takes and what kinds of data the method returns. We call this the signature. So to calculate a tip, I need a bill amount and I need a tip indication, and I'm going to return an amount, all of which are doubles. So we're going to input 2 doubles and return 1 double. Then I'm going to write up some examples to see how I imagine that this function will work. And let's call the method calculate tip. And if the bill was $50 and I want to leave a $20 tip or 20% tip, it should return 10. If the bill was $100, but I only want to leave a 15% tip, it should return 15. let's start an implementation. And from the signature, we know something about what that should look like. It's going to return a double. And from the examples, we know what the method's going to be called. And from the examples and from the signature, we know what the parameters are. And we can go ahead and provide a simple implementation for this. Let's go ahead and run the methods with the examples that we've already gotten. First compile, and then run. And the examples say, if I put in 50 for the amount and 20 for the tip, then I should get back 10. I got back 1,000. Something isn't quite right. The problem is that the tip is given as a percentage, not as an absolute number. Let's fix that. And let's try it again. And the result is as we expected. Let's try the other example. And there's the result, just the way we expected it. 15. So in the beginning, it might look like these are a lot of extra steps to do for something that's quite simple, and that is correct. However, as things get more involved, this will make it a lot easier to create working methods.